happened, I think it happened the first week of pre-season. It was my hamstring, and I felt good the first week, actually. And I felt strong, and like I was running well. And then something didn't feel too good, but I think my mistake was I should have stopped then and said, give it 2 days to rest. And but I just thought, no, I'll keep training. And then I had, a really small tear in it. And then I came back after 2 weeks, and like I'm usually not someone who's injured, so I don't think I've missed many games in my life because of injury. But so I think I tried to rush back, and I thought I was ready, and I was training, but it didn't feel strong. But I think I was trying to convince myself, no, it's good, it's fine. And then in the game at Maritimo, after I think it was 10 minutes when I came on, I felt a big pull. I've missed a lot of time now, I think it's 5 weeks, but I'm back in training, which I'm really happy about. It's not nice when you have to train by yourself and you see everyone training and everyone's playing games, but it's been actually a hard experience for me because I've never been injured, but I guess I learned from it. And now I'm back in training. Maybe I need to work a little bit on my fitness to catch up, but I feel good again and I'm ready to go. I think it just depends on what you look at, to be honest. I think 2016, the situation was like quite difficult because there was a lot more, you couldn't really make any errors because we was fighting relegation. I think the club has kicked on from that time, and I think the squad is probably stronger now. So there was good players then, don't get me wrong, there were some very good players. But I think as a whole squad, it's probably more stronger now. That's the football aspect. But in terms of any other things I'm trying to think of, I think the fans were always the same, always really passionate. Yeah, so they've always been the same. My career, I came through at Sheffield United. That's my hometown. I joined the academy, I think, at 13 or 14 years, and then I progressed to the first team, and it's actually a really good academy. In my age group was Kyle Walker, who's at Manchester City now. My best friend as well, Cal Norton, he's at Swansea City. And there's a few of the other players in our generation who are playing in the Premier League. Yeah, so it was a good place to learn how to play football. I played in Romania for Gazmetan first. It was difficult. At Sheffield United, we were in the Premier League, and it was so difficult for young players to get a chance. So I thought, oh, I'll go abroad and try play somewhere else. And Gazmetan, I remember, when the Europa League that year, and I thought it would be a good opportunity. I went there, and it made me grow a lot because I was living by myself in a different culture and language. I did well there, and then I signed for Steaua Bucharest, and that was a great experience, from the fact that it was probably, well, it is the biggest team there, and everybody sort of supports it, and we had a huge expectation every game, and yeah, so that's it, yeah. It was unbelievable, honestly. I didn't know what to expect. I knew the level would be good, because I've played with Japanese players before, and they're like so quick and stuff. But in terms of like the culture itself, it's incredible. Like to anywhere, say like England or Portugal, it's different to Western Europe. Like the culture is so different. But yeah, it was really cool. I think the main difference is Portugal is a lot more technical, which suits me more. Romania, it's good, but it's a bit more physical. Yeah, I think in Portugal it's probably a bit faster. But because it's not as physical, it's better for me. Porto's, honestly, I know it might sound a bit stupid, but it's like, I feel like I'm in England, apart from the weather. Yeah, even though it rains a lot here too. But yeah, it's been really easy to adapt. Like, I found everyone so friendly, outside the club and inside the club, and like, just normal people you meet on the street are really friendly, and like, you're quite happy people. Like, people are quite happy. So yeah, it's been quite easy to adapt. Right now it's really good. We've had 7 points out of the last 9 in the championship. At first it was a really difficult start. And when you don't win, the confidence sort of drops, and then you don't win again. And but now that everyone's really positive, and just can't wait for the next game. When you're playing well, and the last game was, I think it was our best performance so far, and we just want the next one. And hopefully I'll be back playing soon as well. Obrigado a todos pelo apoio.